the co we come to the coplanarity of two lines. Okay, how do I know that the two lines that are given to me are coplanar? You are given two lines. Just think. Okay, just think. You are given two lines. You are given two lines. Can you tell me? We are given two lines. Can you tell me how do you ensure that, how do you check whether they lie on the same plane? Because we have discussed there are lines like the skew lines. Okay. So there are lines like skew lines, these two lines. They'll never intersect. You can see that. You extend this, one will go in that direction, and the closest that they have come is this. And we have found out the shortest distance between these two skew lines, right? Now, how do I know that the two lines are coplanar? That means, coplanar, you understand? That means you bring one plane and it contains both of them. How do I know that? So let the straight lines be, how do we specify straight lines normally? Of what form? R minus A is equal to lambda B, that is R is equal to A plus A1 plus lambda B1, and R is equal to A2 plus mu B2. What is A1 here? What does it represent? A1 represents what? It is a point through which the line passes. A fixed point through which the line passes. And B1 is what? B1 is the vector to which the line is parallel. Correct. It is a vector to which the line is parallel. Okay. Now, how do you ensure? What conditions should you check? And you should be able to tell me that these two lines are coplanar. How do you know that? Lambda should be equal to mu. Nothing. Come again. What did you send? What did you say? Sorry, sir. What did you send?
The vector to which those two points are parallel.
Nay, I am not asking the lines to be parallel. I am asking the lines to be coplanar. What I am saying is, how do I know that suppose these two are the lines, L1 and L2 are two given lines in equation form, right? Because in 3D, you will not be even able to imagine what the lines will look like, right? It's a tedious job. Okay, it's a tedious job plotting the whole thing and imagining that whole thing into your mind. This is going like that and that is going like that. No. If and only if you see it on a computer, then only you'll understand. Okay? That to a computer that has got a 3D kind of vision that it gives you. Then only you'll understand, oh fine. So this is a line like that. But actually we have to deal with equations. So think that way. But you'll have to think graphically. That's another chaos. What do we do? See, if these two lines lie in a plane, and then maybe your A1 and A2 are also in the same plane, say like that. You understand how the whole thing is drawn. So this is maybe your Cartesian plane, this is your Cartesian space, then what happens? This is, this vector is A1 vector, this is your A1 vector, and this is your A2 vector. Okay, if I name this line as L1 and this line as L2.
Okay. Understand? Now, if they are coplanar, what do you think A2 minus A1 will be? A2 minus A1 will also be coplanar? Is it not? Huh? A2 minus A1 will also be coplanar. Why? Because A2 minus A1 is represented by this vector. By this vector. A2
minus A1 is this vector.
Is it not? So if the lines are coplanar, A2 minus A1 is also coplanar. And I am telling you 90% of the times, 90% of the times, only two things will come to your help. Only two. What are those? The condition for parallelism of vectors and the condition for perpendicularity of vectors. When we are finding the equations of the line, we used to the hilt the condition for parallelism line. And in plane, we have been using the perpendicular condition. Okay. So always, in fact, if you include both, it will become 100% of the cases. Okay. So can you enforce something such that
see, this is B1 to which it is parallel, right? This is B2 to which it is parallel.
If I cross B1 and B2, I get a vector that is perpendicular to the plane. Is it not? So
just look at this. A2 minus A1 is lies in the plane,
correct? B1 cross B2 is perpendicular to the plane,
is it not? B1 cross B2 is perpendicular to the plane,
correct? Now what do I do? Dot them. If I dot them, I should get 0, and that becomes the condition, is it not?
So therefore, for the lines to be coplanar, see, if the lines are coplanar, then for the lines to be coplanar, what happens? A2 minus A1 dotted with B1 cross B2 is equal to 0. As simple as that. Is it not? A2 minus A1 dot B1 cross B2 is equal to 0. Can you find the Cartesian equivalent of that? Can we find the Exactly. So what is the Cartesian equation for that? Cartesian means involving x, y, z, right? Cartesian equation. Very simple to find out. I have A1 as x1 I cap plus y1 j cap plus z1 k cap, A2 as x2 I cap plus y2 j cap plus z2 k cap. What is your B1? B1 is normally A1 I cap plus B1 j cap plus C1 k cap. What is B2? These are direction ratios.
A2 I cap plus B2
exactly. C2 k cap. Okay. Now what is A2 minus A1? A2 minus A1 is equal to x2 minus x1 I cap plus y2 minus y1 j cap plus z2 minus z1 k cap. Okay. So, what is B1 cross B2? B1 cross B2 is given by this IJK. What else? I just write those corresponding terms below that. So, A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2. Okay. At the moment I dot A2 minus A1 with this, what happens? Just IJK gets replaced by the coefficients of IJK here, right? So I get, so A2 minus A1 dot B1 cross B2 is equal to 0. And that is what? That is X2 minus X1, Y2 minus Y1. Z2 minus Z1, A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2 is equal to 0. Why do we keep on harping this condition? The trouble comes when you get the equation in a Cartesian form, right? But what I recommend is you convert a Cartesian equation into a vector equation and then apply the vector funda. That becomes far, far easier, right? We understand.